time for another video, I think. This time I'm going to talk about why did the Halley comet fail. So we go back in time to the early 50s. People were excited about the just at the end of the war, and people just wanted to get on with their lives and rebuild after the war. You had this period of the optimism, like there was a lot of growth in the world at that time. One of the growth things was advances in aviation, notably the AIDS, and so naturally after the war, commercial airline travelers just buying being renewed again. So I was coming to go to Havilland. They wanted to build an airline which was named after an air racer, but this was a... They bought a unique airliner which wasn't piston-controlled, piston-powered. It was powered by the new jet engines, and it would have during the times. So on this put Britain ahead of the Americans and ahead of the Russians. So for plane enters commercial service. But this wasn't without tragedy. The airliners suffered serious crashes and one in Pakistan and one in Egypt, and so nobody ever doubted the aircraft, the airline's airplane safety. That was until a crash in 1954 when a comet taken off by Rome Airport broke up over the Aegean Sea. And people was doing the worst to investigate it. And it was a big shock, so for bam. One thing clear, when they actually did a post mortem on the bodies for some head injuries, burst lungs, and other industries, and they asked Winston Churchill to get to the top and actually asked for the Royal Navy to research the price, and so they actually searched for records and put them onto a frame. Meanwhile, Bullock was hemorrhaging money with $50,000 a day, so the government said, the aircraft, the government decided to let the aircraft fly again. So it was a really bad thing to do because same day, same instant, the aircraft flew up. Because of my bodies, same type of injuries. So they decided to do a lot more tests, they actually devised a new test, worked with the metal model, and found out the passengers would have suffered the same injuries. So figuring out what would work to the airframe, actually constructed a water tank test. A feat for the 1950s, They actually filled the tank with water, filled the tank to recreate blanket systems. So a couple of flowers, a FET crack began to grow around wings, because the windows, instead of being drilled in, was actually nailed in. Basically, it minor damage to the axial fin and aluminous skin. They say it became fatigue crack. So when that the knife door fatigue crack just appeared, and it just failed, and the aircraft just broke up. And in 1958, the Comet airliner flew again, but never had the success it promised. Meanwhile, Boeing, Airbus, and Airbus, and the French Sud-Est launched the Caravelle. Boeing launched the 707, and the Comet was a big hit. And the Comet later became further in decline. The last Comet flew in 1997, but even the tragedy of the Comet just saved it. Probably saved a lot of people learned from mistakes and started making this game bigger. But this was through the cost of the English domination of the aviation industry. I hope you found that educational. See you later.